And we're listening to Kelly Clarkson this morning for a reason, and that's because it's time to check in on the latest buzz in the entertainment world.
Liz and Mike from 105.1 The Buzz joining us live right now. Good morning, guys.
Morning.
Good morning.
Morning. Yeah, we got to talk about Kelly Clarkson. She's making some headlines this week. What's she talking about?
That she will never get married again. So she did an interview and she was talking about since her divorce, like obviously she's not closed off to the idea of maybe dating or finding love down the road, but she has zero plans of ever getting married. She doesn't want to take that step again. Right now, she also really just likes the freedom of being able to do whatever she wants in her career when she's with her kids and that she doesn't have to check in with anybody. And Mike's been divorced and he said he's kind of the same way.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I've been divorced for about 5 years now. Kelly Clarkson, she's still a newbie when it comes to this stuff, but I was able to work on my health, physical and mental afterwards, work on my career, focus on things that I like to do, enjoy life, and I'm right there with her. It's going to take a really special person to ever convert me to go back and getting married again.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for normalizing, like not defining success by marriage and a white picket fence and all that,
no,
you know?
Me and Emily were just talking about this. I said, my favorite thing about these stories is it's none of our business. Who cares? She decided not to get married. Good for her.
It's nice though because it gives you reassurance if you're one of those people who doesn't want to get married. Right. It makes her super relatable and she's so great about sharing so much of her life on her talk show.
Yeah.
I personally though, I'm married and I'm happy in it, but I'm also a very codependent person. So it works out better for me mostly because if I weren't married, I don't think laundry would ever get done. I'd probably never eat, you know, the basics wouldn't take place.
I mean, I'm glad it's working out well for you.
Married.
Yeah.
Good for some, not for all.
Yeah. Good for some.
Well, and let's be honest, with Kelly Clarkson's bank account, you know how celebrity marriages work out. There's not a lot of hoping and dreaming right there. So I don't blame her. Just live your life, be single, and take care of your kids.
That's true. Yeah.
Since you've been gone round two.
Exactly. Good for her. She's just living her best life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And moving on, Keanu Reeves shared how he was feeling when that, you know, the sad Keanu picture was taken. We don't have it, but...
We don't have the rights to show this picture right now, Emma was going to do her best reenactment.
I am doing it
this
right now.
This is sad Keanu. He was kind of slumped over.
He was just, like, slumped down, like, holding, like, a biscuit of some... he's just chilling.
Just looking sad. So what was really going through his mind?
It was a sandwich, not a biscuit. And he said he wasn't sad. He was just thinking about things in life. And he had his sandwich and he was thinking about his sandwich, which I think is the opposite of anything that I would ever do. Usually if I have a sandwich in my hand, I'm smiling. I would only be sad if the sandwich was gone and had been eaten. But he was on Colbert and he was asked about it because this meme went viral. Tons of people took the picture and edited it to be different things to just show Keanu looking sad. And it just turns out that that's just his thinking face when he's sitting on a bench eating.
It makes him relatable. Celebrities, they're just like
us. I was going to say, I relate to this so hard. Like, so many times if I'm not thinking about what my face is doing, you know, I get the, are you okay? Is something wrong? I'm like, no, everything's fine.
The resting naughty word face.
I just have RBF. And that's how my face looks sometimes.
Same. This literally happened to me last night while I was sitting on the couch watching TV with my roommate. He's like, are you okay? What's going on? And I was holding a Christmas tree cake, a Little Debbie Christmas tree cake in my hand. And I was just thinking sweet nothings about it, talking to it like, ooja boo boo, you're going to go in my mouth and it's going to go in my tummy. And that's it.
But you looked miserable.
I looked terrible, like I was sad, but I knew that Christmas tree cake was coming to an end.
Mm-hmm. I must have a way different relationship with food than you guys do, because I am the one dancing with the sandwich in my hand, getting ready to eat the
sandwich. You're just so much more expressive, Liz.
Yeah, and even if it had like mayonnaise instead of mustard, I'd still be like, well, this is a delightful surprise. I will look sad after the sandwich is done because I'll be trying to think about how I can go back in time and eat the sandwich again.
Oh my gosh. I catch myself even on this show sometimes. I'll be looking at Travis and I just have the worst look on my face. I'm fine. Nothing's wrong. Yeah. I'm having
we
a
all do that when
time.
We look at Travis, Emily. Aww. It's okay.
Aww, poor Travis is not here to defend himself.
That's kind of a blessing because I think I have a friendly face. So strangers come up and talk to me all the time and they always assume I work wherever I am. Mm-hmm. I also wear a lot of black, so that might be part of it. But I always have people coming up to me asking what aisle things are on, where they can find something. So I think I might try to like mean my face up a little bit more and maybe they'll be less likely to ask for help.
If you have a sunny disposition, keep it. We have too many Emilys in the world.
We need pleasure-seeking people. If you see me out in public looking mean, I promise I'm not mad at you. I'm just tired. My face just does that.
And a little mean.
Same.
Oh, well, this is mine from here on out.
Well, enjoy the rest of those Christmas tree cakes. Mike, try and crack a little smile. It's all going to be okay.
I'll try.
We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good one.
Bye, friends.
Again, you can listen to Liz and Mike every weekday morning on 105.1 The Buzz.